We make way for the University of Evansville head coach Walter McCarty and my Aces pulling off the upset against Kentucky last night. Good morning, Walter.
Good morning.
How you feeling?
I'm tired. I'm wore out. But I feel great, man. I'm so excited for our program and for our kids, man. They laid it all out last night, so we're really excited.
Give me that pregame speech.
You know what we did, we took the clip from The Pursuit of Happiness, when Will's playing basketball with his son, talking about don't ever let anybody tell you you can't do something. And that's all we heard all week and leading up to this game, that we can't win. And I just wanted to get through to them and let them know we can win. If we're the more connected team, we have a shot.
When did you know that you could pull this off during the game?
Just leading up to practice, our guys have been really good in walkthroughs and in preparation and the scouts, and they all knew what they were going to see. And you know, when they start talking to themselves, they start holding each other accountable. Where we don't have to tell them, hey, this is what to expect. They knew it. The only thing I was concerned with is, you know, when they walk into Rupp, are they going to be intimidated?
Yeah.
And once we got to shoot around, they were really relaxed, a little loose, and I was like, I was thinking, man, they may be too loose, but they were poised and ready to go.
Did you measure the rim like they did in the movie Hoosiers, just to let them know that?
I watched that the night before, and I walked out into the court and I said to my sister Benny, I said, we should have brought the measuring tape.
Oh, Walter, that would have been awesome. You know, I was flipping around last night, and all of a sudden I tune in and Sam Cunliffe is dunking on somebody. And I went, oh, whoa, wait a minute here. And then I stayed with the game. And I thought, you know, Evansville is a 25-point underdog. This is your, you know, this is Calipari. This is Kentucky. McDonald's All-Americans. And all of a sudden I go, you guys aren't going away. Like, but that was the moment I tuned into the game. And I went, and first of all, I remember Sam had been at Arizona State and Kansas, and then, you know, landed in Evansville. Probably didn't know where Evansville was, but
he did not. He did not. He came here on a whim.
Man.
Through some relationships, and we were very fortunate to have him. we got guys that can play, man. We got guys. As you say, Sam was a top kid in high school. DeAndre Williams was an NBA 100 cap kid. I mean, we got kids that can really play, so you know, a lot of people are going on what we did last year when we took over and we had six guys come back. We're a different team, and these guys like the game. They like each other, so we're tough.
They you promised your kids a party if they beat Kentucky, right?
We're gonna have a pep rally today. That's what we're gonna do.
Oh, they want to have a party, Coach. They don't want to have a pep rally.
Well, sometimes you say things, just to try to get a little bit of extra out of them. And then once you do it, you're like, oh, man, did I say that? Did I really say that?
Well, what did Coach Calipari say?
We just told us good job. We have a fun team and just good job, you know, preparing for that game last night. And he wished us good luck.
Didn't you sing the national anthem at an all-star event?
I have, yeah.
Do your players know anything about your background?
They're starting to. They know about the music. They don't really know about the basketball part of it. I don't really talk to them about it that much. I do talk to them about how connected our team was, our championship team was. I really try to get them to understand that piece of it, but not the playing part of it. No, they don't know. They have no clue.
Do they know you were in that movie, He Got Game?
I don't know. I don't know.
Walter, these are things you can use. You can say I was Jesus Shuttlesworth's teammate here.
Yeah, my whole thing is, man, it's about them. I try to keep myself out of the spotlight because I get enough of it being here in my hometown. So everything I do, I try to make it about them and less about me.
Well, it's a little bit about you today, and rightfully so, and certainly your team. Have fun at the pep rally, and congrats, Walter. That was a big moment last night.
I appreciate it. I'm a big fan. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Walter. That's Walter McCarty.
For more Dan Patrick Show, tune into Audience Channel 239 on DirecTV, stream for free on BR Live, or download the Dan Patrick Show app.